Welcome to another Ayehu eyeShare tutorial. Today, we'll see how easy it is to integrate eyeShare with BMC Remedy. The Remedy module provides a bidirectional communication channel between the Remedy and eyeShare. Once the module is defined, eyeShare pulls newly submitted records and updates, translates them into incidents, and displays them on the dashboard while initiating automated workflows. Today, we'll see how eyeShare receives a request to add a user to an Active Directory group from Remedy. eyeShare receives the request and initiates a workflow to handle it. Let's go ahead and see how it works. We'll start by configuring BMC Remedy in eyeShare. We'll start with opening eyeShare Studio, and under Configuration, Modules, let's define New Module, BMC Remedy. Enter the module name, description, and select the device on which the module is installed. Usually, it'll be localhost. Now hit Configure to define module settings. Select the device on which Remedy is installed. The device should be defined in Advanced under Incident Management Devices. Enter username and password. Then press Test Connection in order to establish the connection with your Remedy. Press the Forms button in order to import Remedy forms and define their filters and mapping settings. New Remedy records will be pulled to eyeShare according to the forms list and their defined filters. Select the requested forms. Add the form and press Update in order to update its filters and mappings. In the event that no filters were set, eyeShare will pull all requests of the specific form. Now, hit the Mapping button in order to map the Remedy properties to eyeShare variables. The screen basically replaces the tag mechanism when it comes to incoming Remedy requests. Using it, you can define what value will be assigned to the incident variables without creating a new tag. Use the Severity Mapping tab in order to translate Remedy severities into eyeShare severities. Note that you can assign a static severity or a customized severity, depending on the relevant field in the form. Use the State Mapping tab in order to translate Remedy states into eyeShare states. And now you can note once again that you can assign a static state or a customized state, depending on the relevant field in the form. In our sample, the state called New Request in Remedy represents the state called Down in eyeShare, while Remedy's Closed will translate into Up in eyeShare. Now, hit OK to save your settings. And then hit Update to update the filters and the settings. Save the module settings and make sure it's up. Now, let's create the action rule that will initiate the workflow in the event of an incoming event from Remedy. Go to Studio, Action Rules, and then press New. Enter a rule name, create a new condition, give that condition a name, select the BMC variables, select the required form, select the required status, change the condition between the elements to AND. So now the workflow will be executed whenever a new request related to this form is opened in Remedy. Save the condition and select the required workflow. Hit the Add button, and that'll save your new action rule. Now, let's see the process in action. Here's our Remedy form, including the required username and group. Hit Save to submit the request. Now, here's the eyeShare dashboard, in which you can view the events that are currently open. A new alert, as you can see, appears in the eyeShare dashboard. eyeShare initiates the workflow, which actually adds the required user to the required group. First, it checks whether the user exists in the Active Directory. Then, it checks whether the group exists in the Active Directory and sends an email to the administrator to approve the request. Here's that email. And the administrator is going to approve the request by replying yes. eyeShare spots his answer and adds the user to the group. In addition, it updates the request on the Remedy side by adding text to the Remark field and closing the request. Now let's switch to the Active Directory so we can see the results. John is now part of the eyeShare admins group. As you can see, the request in Remedy is closed. Now, let's quickly review the workflow that we used for this demo. Here's our add user to group procedure. Here's the BMC Remedy action set. Use it to create, get, and update records in your copy of Remedy. Our workflow starts with checking whether or not the user exists. Use the variables icon in order to use the Remedy related variables. Select the required form and variable. Now select your Active Directory server. Make sure to define it in advance under Incident Management Devices. And in the event that the user doesn't exist, eyeShare needs to update the request in Remedy. Select the form, request ID, and the appropriate status. In the event the user does exist, the workflow checks whether the group exists in the same manner. Then, it sends an email to the administrator for approval. In the event that he replies yes, eyeShare adds the user to the group. And updates the Remedy with the status closed. This concludes our BMC Remedy integration info. For further information, please visit our website at www.ayehu.com.